Before you use a website in one of your assignments, you should ask yourself a few questions to evaluate its quality. Let's try evaluating these three websites about coronary artery disease. Here I have one by the University of Michigan, one by Healthline, and one on everyone's favorite, Wikipedia. Firstly, let's ask if the website is authoritative. So we need to identify an author for each page and see if they're qualified on the topic. When we look at Healthline, this page was last reviewed by a named author, Stacey Sampson. Clicking on her name takes you to a page with a short bio explaining she's a family doctor. The Michigan Medicine site doesn't give a specific author for this page, so we treat the organization as the author. So we'd say this page was authored by the Cardiac Surgery Department of a medical university, the University of Michigan, in the United States. When assessing Wikipedia pages, which can have hundreds or even thousands of authors, one thing you can try is using the page statistics feature on the View History tab to see if there are specific users who are responsible for a large amount of that page's content. Here, a user called Doc James has written the largest portion of this page. Clicking on the username takes you to their profile page, where you can see this user says he's an emergency medicine doctor, and you can review this information to see how authoritative he might be to write on the topic. Next, we'll ask, is the information on this website current? Can we find a date that the page was made or updated? And how up to date does our information need to be? On the Michigan Medicine page, after checking at the top and the bottom, we can't find any information on when this page was last updated. The embedded video gives a review date of the 20th of October 2019, but that only applies to the video and not the rest of the page. And while the footer has a copyright date of 2020, that date is for the entire Michigan Medicine website and not the information on this particular page, so we can't tell how current this page is. The Healthline page actually has two different dates of last review, the 23rd of June 2020 at the top and the 23rd of January 2018 at the bottom. We can probably assume the more recent date at the top is accurate. On the View History tab of the Wikipedia page, you can see that this page has been edited last on the 19th of October 2020, but that only tells us that one small edit was made on that date. Because Wikipedia is generally edited incrementally, little by little, it's very hard to tell when a particular part of the page was last updated. But if a page is edited very frequently, like this one is, the page is probably mostly up to date. Now we'll consider the purpose and the objectivity of the website. One rough way to assess a page's purpose is to see what domain the website has. .com usually means that website is a commercial business. .edu is for schools, universities, and educational institutes. And .org is for community, not-for-profit, and political organizations. Also think about why someone has decided to collect and publish this information, and look at the type of language used. The Healthline page has a lot of advertisements, and the language on their About page is more emotional than what you would see in, for example, your textbook. The Michigan Medicine page is designed to give information to the cardiac surgery patients at their clinic, but it does seem to have some marketing purpose as they're offering their appointments and services on the site. And Wikipedia is a not-for-profit organization aiming to share knowledge, and their editors are told to use a neutral point of view. But you have to ask yourself whether the individual contributors have stuck to that purpose. Lastly, we ask if the website is reliable. How much can we trust its information? You'll need to use your own knowledge of the topic and your learnings from class to assess whether the information on a website is accurate and therefore reliable. Another way to assess reliability is to check whether any sources or references are listed and whether those sources are high quality themselves. The Wikipedia page has over 100 sources given, and most seem to be either peer-reviewed articles or reports by well-respected organizations like the WHO, World Heart Federation, and the US National Institute of Health. The Healthline page lists 7 sources, which are a mix of peer-reviewed articles and some websites. Some of those websites are by government or medical institutions, and others are consumer-focused sites, similar to Healthline. The Michigan Medicine page only lists one source, the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute. Remember, you may need to read the source itself to make sure the website you're assessing has interpreted the source correctly. Now, gather up all your thoughts and decisions about each website. You can use any ranking or rating system that works for you. So, what do you think? Having looked at each of these websites, would you use them for your assignments? And if you would, when would you use them? Would you use them just for background reading? Maybe to find other more authoritative sources from the footnotes? Maybe to find accurate images or video, or as a final reference in your assignment? If you need more help assessing websites, or with anything to do with research and referencing, go to www.library.qut.edu.au/help.